Our story begins in the middle of the 40s, when a hopeful young soldier called Sam... we're not doing that? Our story begins in the middle of last Tuesday, where a hopeless young freeloader called Sam is sipping a fancy cup of coffee with a name nobody can pronounce. Sam was born with a silver spoon in his mouth. But not the actual spoon that he has in his mouth now. That is a different spoon. But a figurative spoon that represents all the wealth and attention that he has been receiving from his parents. And their butlers. And their butlers' parents. You're a douche, aren't you, Sam? Blink twice if yes. He can't hear me. This is Sam's girlfriend. Also not being heard by Sam. She's mad at Sam for his lack of responsibility produced by his large wealth. She also mentions the fact that Sam has forgotten her birthday for the third year in a row. Sam's girlfriend is upset. As with most rich and famous brats, Sam does not pick up on that. Instead, he decides to lay this gem.
Things just work out for me, baby. I can't just run around and do stuff. I'd end up with a limp spine
then,
or something.
Sam's girlfriend does something she should have done a long time ago. Sam is laying unconscious on the floor. He gathers his strength and makes an effort to get up. Then he makes another effort to stand up straight. Sam is hit in the head so hard, he has to remind himself how to walk. He takes a right step. Then he takes a left step. Good job, Sam! You're very good at existing.
How dare you startle my child!
An overprotective mother hurls a cup of coffee in Sam's face. He has to blink rapidly to regain his vision.
Say something, Harold!
Oh, gee.
How is our son going to become a respected politician if he can't fend for himself?
I thought he was going to become an actor.
Oh, what's the difference?
Sam remembers the one thing he's good at, paying for stuff. So he turns around to pay for his beverage. Sam pays the guy 500 euros, barely covering the coffee.
Thanks for the tip, douchebag.
Sam decides to hurl another 500 at the guy. Not such a douchebag after all. Sam is hurling stacks of 500s left and right. He has no perception of money. Sam is about to spend his whole weekly allowance on tipping a barista named Tony. He really was hit hard in the head.
Holy feces! I'll just start my own coffee shop!
Once again, Sam makes someone quit their job by tipping them too much.
So long! Suckers!
Sam spends a decade making his way out the door, which is pretty good for a guy. As Sam waggles outside, he sees his girlfriend on the other side of the road. Sam pulls himself together and rushes towards his soon-to-be ex-girlfriend. This is when a septic tank truck approaches Sam with an average speed of 90 kilometers per hour. The impact renders him 8 types of dead. Who knew a bottle to the face would result in such a terrible fate for Sam? But a bottle won't be the only thing that will meet Sam's face today. There's also the ground in hell. Sam does not like being dead a single bit. He also hates the eerie feeling of not having any cash on him. Then, he finds 7 glowing notes in his pocket. That makes him feel reasonably better. He checks out that horrible sound he's hearing. Not the horrible sound of the screaming souls around him. The other horribly irritating sound. The source of the sound is none other than obliteration and oblivion, extermination and extinction, the end, decease and demise, the Grim Reaper, death. He's trying to do a kickflip on a skateboard and is dressed like a douchebag for some reason. In his coarse, horrifying voice, he lays this on Sam.
Yo, yo, yo! You must be Sam from the info I was provided.
Then he takes a second look at Sam, and his eye sockets widen.
Holy feces, dude! Your soul be like a diamond! Let me cut you a deal that we can seal. For reals? Aight, man, it decided.
The notes in Sam's pocket are something called a shred of life. Every soul has at least one, and it is the biggest unit in Hell's currency. Followed by quality of life, school of life, sound of life, meaning of life, and thug life.
If you give me your shreds, I'll resurrect your face and get you out of hell on one condition. You'll have to survive 24 hours with a handicap I choose under my supervision, bro.
Sam decides to check out the rest of hell before doing any deals with supernatural beings.
Why, hello there, dear sir. Let's see if we can find a job for you. You get to be... ooh, a plumber. That'll be all your shreds, dear sir.
All right, that sounds fair. Yes.
Sam notices that the souls that get into hell are forced to get a job and become functioning souls of society. For most people, this is okay, but for Sam, it's horrifying. He hurls his shreds at death like he's never hurled piles of money before.
Why, hello there, dear sir. Let's see if we can find a job for you. You get to be... ooh, a minesweeper. That'll be all your shreds, dear sir.
Could be worse. Whatever. Kinda sounds fun.
Why, hello there, dear sir. Let's see if we can find a job for you. You get to be a struggling freelance artist. Oh my, that'll be all your shreds, dear sir.
No! This is truly hell!
Well, looks like it's time for lunch, dear sirs and madams. Take all your concern-related concerns up with upper management. See you in 5 hours.
Sam has seen enough. He goes back to death and his deal. He keeps the last shred for the next time he meets the gatekeeper of hell. Whenever that's going to be.
Hehe. Aight, bro. I only get to do these deals annually. But if you really want to live in biz, you have to do it manually. Also, I will stop speaking in rhymes now.
Sam has just traveled through time, space, and logic, and finds himself fully alive, and more importantly, rich again. His joy is only dimmed by the fact that he can't move at all. This is when he shows up. Death.
Yo, yo, yo! Oh, yeah, you look horrible. I mean, you look great, bro. You be okay? Can you hear me? Blink twice if yes. Oh, cool. You be alive. Everything be fine. Aight, so, this here be the dealing biz. All your body functions be manual, so you kinda have to do stuff on purpose. You be turning kinda blue. Might wanna consider breathing. Alright! Bitchin'! You be blinking and breathing? That be bitchin'! So, alright. Go survive for a day, and I'll let you live normally for the rest of your life. If you somehow die within the next 24 hours, you'll go to hell and I'll keep your shreds forever. I'll be over there doing kickflips if and you need me.
Once again, Sam has to make an effort to get up. This time, he has to focus on his spine. And, once again, he has to remind himself how to walk.
Oh, by the way, dude, you be getting late for work.
Sam does something that resembles walking toward the bathroom.
Gonna do a kickflip now.
Sam tries out a strange maneuver by stepping with the same leg twice.
Friggin' skateboard.
Sam has some trouble with his posture and has to focus on his spine.
Yeah! Aye, let's see here.
How hard is it to blink, Sam? He has to use his opposite leg to get up again.
Bending my knees. Oh, what I be doing wrong, yo? Let's see.
Sam has some trouble with his posture and has to focus on his spine.
Yeah.
You're impressing no one, Sam.
Gonna do a kickflip.
Sam holds on to that toothbrush like his life depends on it. Sam is dumb enough to breathe in with his mouth full of water. He has to cough. Sam refuses to learn from his mistakes and has to cough again. Sam passes out from the lack of oxygen. It's going to be a long day. With clean teeth, Sam is ready to smile. He won't for at least 24 hours, though. Sam tries to take a leak.
Hey, dude, have you seen my...
Sam has some trouble with his posture and has to focus on his spine. Sam takes a leak everywhere. One empty bladder later, Sam moves on. Your spine, Sam! It matters! Sam tries to take a shower. He looks like a mantis that's trying to explain to someone how a bicycle works. Sam passes out from the lack of oxygen again. Sam is clean as a whistle. Good job, Sam. Sam passes out from the lack of oxygen again. Clean and empty, Sam decides to find some clues.
Friggin' skateboard. Hi, let's see here. Yeah! Yeah! Hi, let's see here. Relax my body, bending my knees. Oh, what I be doing wrong, yo? Let's see. Yeah.
Sam can open doors now. Clever boy. Sam enters his wardrobe. What will he wear today? He picks a pair of blue jeans. The ugly ones. Sam successfully puts on his pants. Feeling more accomplished than ever, he proceeds to find a jacket. Only the best one will do. He settles for a mediocre one. Humble. Fully clothed, Sam is ready for the day. P.S. He's not. He puts on his shoes, living the dream of having shoes on. Sam walks down the stairs with great Sam decides to hurl himself down the stairs. Apparently too used to hurling money around. Flappy Rooster is Sam's favorite game. He has no time for playing with a Flappy Rooster right now, though. That was either supposed to or not supposed to happen. We'll never know.
Following the story at this time, and gang wars are still an escalating problem at Bridge Street, where the police are struggling to regain control. Commuters are advised to...
Hey, Lucy! I'm home!
Oh, hey, dude. Still alive, huh?
There is a note saying, sent over a maid to make you breakfast. Don't breathe in while chewing. Love, Mom. Despite his mother's warnings, Sam breathes in. Disgusting, but necessary. Sam finishes his food like the big boy he is. Good job, Sam. Sam decides to try his luck on some coffee drinking. Sam's coffee is so hot, he blows on it before taking a sip. Out of cups, out of hope. Or not. He decides having third-degree burns in his mouth. With some coffee in his system, Sam finds it easier to exist. He finally makes it out the front door, beaten, terrified, stupid.
Dude, I am totally gonna kickflip over your car. When I got there, you might want to get that hood fixed. It be loose. I'll just get in the car. Now, while you have the clutch down, press the gas pedal. As you let go of the clutch, the car will start moving in biz. Good job, dude. You ain't as useless as you look, know what I mean? Now, to stop, you gotta move your right foot to the brake pedal.
Left for us, he means.
And obviously, press it down. Give stopping a go, dude. Nice! Now, start driving again, like I showed you. And obviously, you turn left and right with your arms. If you want to drive faster, you gotta use the stick, baby. To upshift, you press down the clutch and then yank the stick. Obviously, you can't turn left when your hand be on the stick. So to turn left, you have to move your hand back to the steering wheel, y'all.
And so Sam and the Lord of Damnation are on their merry way towards a new adventure. Together. Cozy.
Dude, there be an old lady on the road. Left. We almost killed that lady. She ain't due for another... a few hours. Listen, if you kill somebody before their time because I messed up your motoring skills, I will be in deep feces, okay? So keep your eyes on the road. If you almost kill someone, I'll stop the car, yo. But then, you'll have to start it all over again with the clutching biz, right? You'd be good to go. Anyway, dude, you're probably wondering why all this biz be happening. To tell you the truth, bro, it be all part of bureaucratic bull feces. The shreds of life you give to those gatekeeping... Oh, go right, bro!
Close one!
As I was saying, the shreds of life you give to those gatekeepers to get into hell, yeah, they be distributed between the bank of hell and Satan. Oh, yeah, dude. The big S. Right, yo. Holy feces! Anyway. Then, the Bank of Hell distributes their share as salary among the citizens of Hell. Do you know how much... Right, dude? Holy feces! Anyway, do you know how much my salary be? A little less than a burger flipper at Mickey Demon's, yo. And a little more than an elementary school. Right, yo? Holy feces. Anyway. A little less than a burger flipper at Mickey Demon's, yo. And a little more than an elementary school teacher. You know what I be saying? Up high. Never mind. A soul has one, maybe two shreds on him. Depending on his life quality. And I don't want... What be that gray cloud in the middle of the road? Oh, feces! That be a whole school of old ladies! Get ready! Right! Ah! Left! Ah! Right! Ah! Left! Ah! Yo! Ah! What be up with all those old ladies today, bro? Hey, Sam. You're never gonna make it to work on time with all these grannies everywhere, dude. What do you say we take a shortcut?
And so Sam drives the car to a place he has never been before. A place called Bridge Street.
Oh, dude. I hope it be safe here. Hope there be no, say, crazy gang members here or nothing. No, really, though. Where be the crazy gang members? Oh, crazy gang members. Oh, excuse me. You be a crazy gang member? Ooh, don't you worry. I know where the crazy gang members be.
To Death's surprise and Sam's relief, the gang members are lying dead on the ground. This is when Death notices a distinct silhouette in the distance.
What be the deal, bro? Why be there... Oh,
the silhouette is contention and enmity, bloodshed and hostility, strife and strike, struggle, battle, war. She is neither wearing dumb clothes nor doing kickflips. She is just standing there after a job well done.
Oh, holy feces, it be her! Hop in my breath. Just be cool. Be cool. Okay, just don't be yourself. Hey, War, how it be going, babe? Wanna hitch a ride in these sweet wheels?
I yell to one that can be killed, but will to get me well. I'm fast, right to face the shield and don't just clip it at all. I kill the one.
Oh, holy feces, here she comes.
Hey, girl, where to?
Just shut up and take me to the metro. Aren't you supposed to, like, reap a bunch of people, knucklehead?
I was, but then I got bored, so now I hang out with my buddy Sammy here. Ain't it right, Sammy?
Stop here. Okay, we can go. So instead of guiding endless amounts of confused souls to the afterlife, you waste time with this dumb, ugly mortal. Stop here.
Stop, dude.
Ah! Oh, God!
Okay, let's go.
You want a cigarette?
You're so annoying. You know I'm trying to quit. Fine, give me one. I hate you. Go right here. Stop here.
Stop, dude!
Stop. Okay, we can go.
Hey, guess what? I totally landed a kickflip today.
Take a left. Stop here. Okay, we can go. Wow, you really landed a kickflip? That's kind of hot.
Yeah, or... Well, I almost landed a kickflip.
You know, Famine can do a frontside kickflip.
Such a show.
Stop here. Okay, we can go.
Oh, dang it, the grandmas be back. Left.
Gah!
Right.
Oh!
Yo, go left.
Gah!
Yo.
Ah!
Left.
Gah!
Oh, I never be getting used to those grannies.
Stop here. This is where I get off.
Hi, babe. I'll see you around.
Whatever.
What you be looking at? Oh, snap! You be getting late for work, bro! Step on it as hard as you can if we gonna make it! Go, go, go! Faster, faster!
Yo, faster! Faster! Yo, dude, faster! Faster, dude! Get up to fifth gear! Almost fast enough, dude! Step on it! Yo, faster! Faster! Almost fast enough, dude! Step on it! Oh, feces! Stop! Stop! Feces! Did we kill somebody? Oh, please let it just be a rock or a hipster or something.
Sam goes out the door to see what happened.
Man, oh.
He only has to follow Death's crying voice.
Oh, God, no, 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 no. Feces! This guy wasn't due. He wasn't due. What be I gonna do? Hey, wait a minute. Hey, Sam, can I borrow your last shred of life? Blink twice if yes. All right! Yo, 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 let's do a deal that we can steal, yada, yada, yada. Slap your salmon 57 times in 24 hours or you'll be dead forever. Now, get out of here. I just had to. Anyway, let's get out of here.
Weird. It's another busy day in Robocorp Inc., where they produce automatic robots for fun, convenience, and most importantly, safety. Finally, Sam makes it to work, and only by having the most terrifying morning of his life. He waggles towards the entrance, still shaky after the events of his trip.
Awesome, dude. So can my prosthetic eye.
Ah, Robocorp's proudest and newest invention, the Maidbot. It is rumored to have over 3,000 functions, including pest control, rest control, and guest control. And it can make you a nice cup of coffee. For the 7 billionth time, Sam has lost the key card to his office and has to request a new one from reception. We've seen Sam do weirder things. Sam focuses all his brain energy on trying to speak well-formulated sentences.
Hello, Mr. Samuel. How can I help you?
You are a wordsmith, Sam.
Of course, sir. Try not to lose it again.
Sam takes the card and heads for his office. The elevator is occupied. Sam has no time for waiting. He wants to get around to doing nothing as soon as possible.
And then, he meets his old nemesis. Stairs.
Taking his keycard up the stairs, that's the real challenge. Sam hurls himself down the stairs. No one cares to ask. Sam goes in the third door to his office area.
Yeah, it is a dangerous job, but the health benefits are awesome, dude! I blew off my leg.
This is Ingrid, Sam's secretary. Since Sam never gets any calls or does any actual work, Ingrid has a level 80 warrior in every game ever made. Sam's office. A waste of space, according to everyone ever. Sam doesn't do much at work, simply because his father doesn't let him. According to Samuel Sr., he only has to show up, shut up, and not mess up. This gives Sam plenty of time to sharpen his skills on his favorite game, Flappy Rooster. Yes, he has one here too. Sam decides to try and beat his record of 10,000 points. Someone knocks on Sam's door. It is Ingrid.
Mr. Samuel, Mr. Welfenberg wants to speak with you.
Also known as Samuel Sr., Sam's dad.
He seems kinda angry. Take the elevator to his office.
The soothing elevator music sets the mood for productivity and not asking questions. All of Sam's interactions with his old man have lately been reduced to short meetings in his office. This is Samuel Sr. He owns RoboCorp Inc. And he is tired of the fact that Sam is always late to work. Sam is keeping the morale of his company down, and it is time for him to work for his money.
No more fancy offices. You are starting at the bottom. Today, you start as a lithium inserter in the storage room. Go down to the basement and get to work!
Sam has done weirder things to impress his dad. Lepidium is a ridiculously rare material packed with energy. It is the key ingredient to the success behind the robots in RoboCorp Inc. Its energy is measured in consciousness, and even just a little bit of the stuff could do wonders for artificial intelligence. Despite all his efforts, Sam ends up working for the first time in his life. At least he's alive. Sam's job is ridiculously simple. He has to pull the lever so a chunk of Lephidium comes down. Then he has to put the required amount of Lephidium in a robot's slot.
Dude, your dad couldn't have picked a worse day to make you work with this stuff. I guess we'll be back in hell in no time. Gonna do a kickflip now. Friggin' skateboard. Alright, let's see here. Yeah! Relax my body. Bending my knees. What'd I be doing wrong, yo? Let's see. Yeah! Yeah! Gonna do a kickflip now. Friggin' skateboard. Alright, let's see here. Yeah! Relax my body. Bend my knees.
Sam figures out how to open an automatic door. Impressive, Sam.
Yeah. Oh, what I've been doing wrong, yo? Let's see. Gonna do a kickflip now. Friggin' skateboard. Alright, let's see. Yeah! That's my body. Bending my knees. Oh, what have I been doing wrong, yo? Gonna do a kickflip now. Nah! Friggin' skateboard. Alright, let's see. Yeah! Relax my body. Bending my knees.
Blink, Sam, blink!
Yo, Sam, I can totally kickflip over that box.
Death says, having never actually landed a kickflip in his entire existence.
Yeah!
Death manages to spill Lephidium all over every robot in the basement.
Oh, no! No, 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 no! Oh, no, Sam! No, Sam! What are we gonna do, yo?
Every robot in the basement gets too conscious and escapes. Sam has to get out of work ASAP, and this time with a good excuse.
Don't you see, you doorknob? I was directly involved in waking those things to life. If they hurt anyone, I will be in 10 types of feces.
Sam decides to take a last sip of water before his demise.
Blink, Sam! Blink! Sam short-circuits the door! He will live to breathe manually another day!
Gosh darn it! You'd be right, you beautiful son of a lemur! We do have to stop them! Be what I be talking about, dude.
We are in deep feces, fellas. Someone exposed the robots to too much lefidium, and now they are all conscious. They are headed straight for Mushroom Orphanage. Population, 300 lovely kids.
All the robots that became conscious were produced in the last 10 years. That means they have a large arsenal of functions, but are fragile as hell. We will have to use an old and sturdy manual bot to be able to take them down. It is controlled manually.
But gosh darn it, Johnson! None of us have done anything manually for years!
Oh, I still do things manually sometimes. Maybe I can...
Told you she was due in a few hours.
Do we have any volunteers at all for this task? It is not that I believe in you, son, but I've never seen you actually do anything on your own before. So, at this point, I just want to see what happens.
Chillax, bro. You ain't on your own. Yo, yo, yo! We need to blow up those robots before they hurt somebody!
Old Death is pointing the way! Sam don't stop to ask why.
Oh, what the feces! Shoot at that door, yo, so we can keep going. Shoot it 2 more times, bro. Your gun kind of sucks.
Sam turns that door into toothpicks. He's packing heat.
Oh, for feces sake, another door. Just use your missiles this time.
Sam blasts through the door. He's done messing around.
Hey!
be a door we can't blow through. Throw me behind it so I can open it up. I'd be ready, but be careful. What if I just walk?
He hurls death without blinking. His only amigo. He has to breathe manually while his friend is gone. He rejoins his day-long friend. It's a touching reunion.
Oh, feces.
Can't get too close to those things. They get edgy.
Oh, watch your battery, you biz. All right, dude. Good to go. Wait with us.
Sam takes out the first robot like he's taking out the trash.
I changed my mind. I'd be alive. Thank God.
He encounters a running fella. He pops him good.
Wait, I ain't ready. Okay, I'll be ready.
Encounters one of them old blue bots. Gotta chuck old death at him.
I changed my mind. I checked.
Oh God, that was horrible.
Sam feels horrible for what he did. Throws up a little to feel better. Big old fella pops up in front of me.
What if I just walk?
Oh my God! It's getting right by me!
What if I...
Pete busts him up like he's getting paid for it. Paid and painted.
You blew it up! You are a douchebag!
A
Sam needs to use his shield more!
Go, Emmy! I changed my mind! You see how I beat that guy up? Would be cool if you threw cars around.
He shoots missiles. He shoots missiles.
Wait, I ain't ready. I changed my mind. What if I...
Sam feels horrible for what he done, so he upchucks a little bit and feels a lot better.
end of the trail. And the orphanage is still standing. Maybe a good day after all.
Whew! No dead kids. Oh, we'd be lucky.
But then, the wind turns. There's one last robot needing to be taken care of. The Maidbot.
Oh, feces, dude. Hold on to your flappy rooster. Good, dude. Oh, you got a good dude. You got a good dude. Oh, you got her good, dude. Finish her off, dude. Do it.
Hundred orphans go to heaven, which is a totally nice place, by the way. But death, he caused Satan at least 300 shreds of life. He ain't gonna be happy. And Sam, well, he's got a lot on his mind right about now. I don't know what came over me. Anyway, let's continue the story, shall we?
Oh, feces! I have to disappear forever before he finds me. Just gots to do one thing first.
Death has risked a meeting with the one he's trying to avoid for one simple item. The Skatemate 3000! Super easy to do kickflips with.
Oh, I'll be so close! I can almost taste the kickflips.
But then he arrives. The Angel of Darkness. The evil spirit, Mephistopheles, Lucifer, the king of hell, Beelzebub, Satan.
Oh, Satan. Hey, I wasn't. What you be up to, bro?
Oh, you know, Satan things. Busy, busy, busy. Like a fly.
That's a... Yep, a good one.
So, I hear you've killed 300 hairless apes.
Kill, that's it. I was passing by while it happened, yes, but...
And they were too young to sin. So... They aren't even coming to hell.
I can pay you back. I have 300 shreds.
And where did you get 300 shreds. If you didn't steal them from me.
Weekend jobs.
You are in deep feces.
Meanwhile, Sam is trying to pull himself out of deep feces. There are only a few hours left to his curse. Right as Sam is about to go to bed, she arrives. War.
Can you believe that idiot? He went ahead and got himself thrown in hell jail, so now I have to be both death and war. That's double shifts and no extra pay. Anyway, it says here that you were supposed to die almost 24 hours ago.
Sam tries to say something along the lines of, "No, no, please don't. This is no fun. This is no fun." But his lack of competence in the art of speaking manually only results in this happening. Once again, Sam is in hell.
Come on, I'm supposed to take you to the gate.
Why, hello there, dear sir. Let's see if we can find a job for you. You get to be... ooh, the sun. Huge company. You get your own office, and you get to play Flappy Rooster all day. That'll be all your shreds, dear sir.
Sam remembers that he has none left.
Oh, no shreds of life? Oh, I'm terribly sorry, sir, but this means you have to go to hell jail. Guards! Have a nice day.
Oh, no shreds, eh? Well, it can happen to the best of us, mate. Let's take you to hell jail then, shall we? Such fun.
Take all your concern-related concerns up with upper management.
What's your favorite movie, mate? Mine is It's a Wonderful Life.
There you go, mate. Hope you'll have a good time.
Let's bring him some food.
Take all concern-related concerns up with upper management.
And there he is. Death.
Yo, 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 Sam. Oh, you came to save me. Oh, you truly be a bro, bro. So, what be the plan? Ooh, dude, that be hardcore. But I suppose that be the only way. Aye, when the god comes back, I'll rip him in half and put you inside. You should be able to control him with your manual powers. Here he comes.
Do you like strawberry or chocolate cupcakes, mate? I brought them both just in case.
Heck yeah! It worked, bro! Alright, crush these bars, and then get your butt to the spot where we met for the first time. We be getting out of here, yo!
As the still warm insides of the guard squeeze against Sam's skin, he thinks about how lucky he is to be rich, so he can pay for all the hours of therapy after this. Sam violently kills a guard. He'll just be reborn as a demon anyway. Of course, Sam doesn't.
I'm terribly sorry, sir, but I'll have to take you back to China.
Sam slays another guard. Crazy and desperate. And there goes another one.
You're not being very nice, right?
This goes on for a while. Let's just see what happens.
Can't we all just be friends?
Alright, let me just open up a portal. Oh, snap.
Silly, hairless ape. I'll make your pain beyond imaginable.
Time to mention those concern-related concerns, Sam.
Oh. Beep.